इंदिरा गांधी, द ओनली फीमेल प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ इंडिया, द आयरन लेडी ऑफ इंडिया, द डॉटर ऑफ द फर्स्ट इंडियन प्राइम मिनिस्टर, एंड द वुमन हु पुश्ड द इंडिपेंडेंट डेमोक्रेटिक इंडिया टुवर्ड्स इट्स डार्केस्ट फेज. बट वॉट लेड टू दिस? Why a leader loved and admired by her people suspended their basic fundamental rights? Here is the story of the infamous Raj Narayan case that was one of the leading or the most important factor that led to emergency. The state of emergency in India can only be imposed if the President of India, in legal language, perceives the threat to the nation from internal and external sources, or in case of financial crisis. There have only been 3 instances when state of emergency has been declared in India. The first was from 26th of October 1962 to 10th of January 1968 during the Indochina War, when the security of India was threatened from external sources. The second being from 3rd December 1971 to 21st March 1972 during the India-Pakistan War, as a result of which Bangladesh was born. And the third and the most controversial one existed from 25th of June 1975 to 21st of March 1977. This was announced on the basis of internal disturbance. Let's start from 1971. In 1971, India held its 5th general election. Before the elections in 1969, the Congress Party was split into 2 camps, with Indira Gandhi leading Congress R and Kumaraswamy Kamaraj and Morarji Desai leading Congress O. Despite the split, Indira Gandhi was able to maintain her hold over the power. In 1971 elections, Congress O formed a pre-poll alliance with several parties like Bharatiya Janata, Swatantra Party, etc. This election was famous for the opposition's campaign on the motto Indira Hatao or Remove Indira versus Gandhi's campaign on Garibi Hatao or Eradicate Poverty. Despite all the efforts from the opposition camp, Indira's Congress R won a thumping majority with 352 seats out of 518 seats in Lok Sabha. Now moving from the national side, let's focus on Indira Gandhi's controversial election in her Lok Sabha constituency of Rae Bareli. In Rae Bareli, Raj Narayan of Ram Manohar Lohia's party, SSP, an ally of Morarji Desai's Congress O, fought the election against Mrs. Gandhi. He was so confident of his victory that he even began celebrating it before the election results were even announced. But when the results came and Indira won by more than 1 lakh votes, he was shocked. He didn't accept the defeat and filed a petition in the Allahabad High Court against Indira Gandhi for indulging in malpractices and violating the Representation of People Act 1951. This act specifies the conduct of a candidate in an election in India. He accused her of using government machinery for ensuring her re-election and distributing liquor and blankets among people. He also said that she had exceeded the maximum amount allowed to be used in elections of 35,000 rupees. Indira was represented by lawyer Nanabhoy Palkhiwala and Raj Narayan by Shanti Bhushan. After fighting the case for almost 4 years, on 12th of June 1975, Allahabad High Court Justice Jagmohan Lal Sinha found Mrs. Gandhi of violating the electoral law in a 1971 campaign by securing the services of Yashpal Kapoor, a government official, by appointing him as her campaign organizer and availing herself of meetings arranged by local officials and using the police force in the campaign. Her election from Rae Bareli was declared null and void. She was barred from bearing any elected office for 6 years. He ordered Congress R to remove Mrs. Gandhi of all her posts within 20 days. This sparked a series of protests from Congress R workers all over the country. Mrs. Gandhi appealed against the judgment in Supreme Court, and Justice V.R. Krishna Iyer, on 24th of June 1975, upheld the High Court judgment that ordered all the privileges Mrs. Gandhi received as an MP be stopped and that she be debarred from taking part in parliamentary proceedings. However, she was allowed to continue as a Prime Minister pending the resolution of her appeal. J.P. and Morarji Desai called for anti-government protests. The next day, J.P. at a rally in Delhi said that a police officer must reject the orders of government if the order was immoral and unethical.
उन सत्याग्रहियों में जयप्रकाश नारायण भी होगा, मैं भी सत्याग्रह उस दिन करूंगा और वहां चाहे मेरी गिरफ्तारी हो चाहे जो भी हो है, अब न्याय होगा, जमाना पलटा है, ये क्रांति होगी, ये सारा संघर्ष करेगा, हमारे साथ इस आंदोलन के साथ सहयोग करो, अपनी ड्यूटी भी करो, जितना हुक्म होता है तुमको उतना करो, लेकिन जो हुक्म ऐसा हो जो तुम्हारी आत्मा खिलाफ हो, तुम्हारी जमीर के खिलाफ हो, अनैतिक हो, उस हुक्म को हरगिज मत मान लो, ये तो महात्मा गांधी जी का हुक्म था अंग्रेजी राज के जमाने में।
Such a statement was taken as a sign of inciting rebellion in the country.
एक जना इस हद तक गया कि अगर फौजी किसी हुक्म को गलत समझे तो उसको न माने। यह कार्यक्रम इस महीने के 29 तारीख से शुरू होने वाला था। हमें जरा भी संदेह नहीं कि ऐसा कार्यक्रम शांति और आर्थिक स्थिति को घोर खतरा पैदा करता।
Later on the night of 25th of June, President Fakhruddin Ali Ahmed declared a state of emergency, citing internal disturbance upon Indira Gandhi's advice.
भाइयों और बहनों, राष्ट्रपति जी ने आपातकाल की घोषणा की है। इससे आतंकित होने का कोई कारण नहीं है। The president has proclaimed emergency.
During the emergency, several main opposition leaders, including Raj Narayan, were arrested, press censored, organizations banned, large number of new laws enacted, and most importantly, all fundamental rights, with the exception of right to life, were suspended. In August, the parliament dominated by Indira's Congress and with almost all opposition leaders jailed, amended the election laws in such a way so to clear them. The New York Times reported the amendment provided in effect that the things the Prime Minister was found to have done during the re-election of 1971 were no longer illegal. We have quoted New York Times here because the Indian media at that time was heavily censored with only reports favoring the government allowed to publish. On 7th of November 1975, the Supreme Court of India overturned the decision of the Allahabad High Court and cleared Mrs. Gandhi of all election fraud charges. In 1977, when the fresh elections were called, Narayan again contested against Indira from bribery and won by more than 50,000 votes. He later served as the Health Minister of India during the Janata Party government, which was the first non-congressional government in India. However, later in 1980, Indira Gandhi rose back to power and again became the Prime Minister of the largest democracy in the world. On the other hand, Narayan this time contested election from Varanasi seat but lost to Congress's Kamla Pati Tripathi. This case is one of the many cases which tells us how the independence of judiciary in India was hampered at the time of Indira Gandhi's government. Though she has been a successful leader for the country and will always be remembered for her magnificent achievements, but the dark side of her government's declaration of emergency will also never be forgotten. Also, we should not forget the bravery of Justice Sinha, which he showed by passing an order against the then Prime Minister of the country.